Ladies and gentlemen, this is a YouTube show in which you are brought Slot Machine Sunday, Money Cards Monday, Tic Tac Tuesday, Whammy Mania Wednesday, Thundercracker Thursday, and Flinging Dice Friday and Saturday Superstarcade. Also wrestling news from Raw, NXT 2.0, AEW Dynamite, NXT UK, Impact Wrestling, SmackDown and 205 Live, and AEW Rampage, and special episodes from Road and Up, Cyber Swaggin', and the Philosophies of Lee McLees. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the YouTube show of fun, of knowledge, strategy, luck and daring, and mental shenanigans. This is WEML TV Channel 77. And now here's the host of the show, live from New Bedford, Massachusetts. It is none other than Eric M. Lima! Thank you very much, Mr. Announcer, for that wonderful intro. Hello, everyone. This is Eric Lima, the five-time Bumbling Bozos Bozy Awards nominee. That's right, and you're watching, and I'm hosting this show, and you're watching WEML TV Channel 77, episode 896 of the show, January 18th, 2022, 2:17 p.m. Update scheduling notes. I always usually try to do the shows. Just to let you guys know, all right, there might be a huge snowstorm coming this Saturday. I don't know. And with the job that I work at, it's going to be very difficult to get out doing my regular routine schedule. I usually get out at 10:30, and I usually come home, do all the stuff, but we'll see what happens, you know. According to some reports, it might miss us, and again, it might not. Who knows for sure. But we'll see. It is the winter time here in New England, so I hope you guys can understand. But the good news is I know exactly what game to play on Saturday Superstarcade should I successfully come home. If I come home really, really late, I'm probably not going to be able to do it. Like usually, I usually do it on Sundays, though. I don't want to call it Sunday Superstarcade. But Saturday Superstarcade for me is just a fancier word of saying video game play. So it's like, oh, I'm going to do a video game play, you know. I don't want to come up with a fancy name, so I combine two of my favorite 80s video game shows, so to speak. You got Starcade, the game show that has video games, and Saturday Supercade, which is the video game cartoon block on CBS. I mishmash them together, call it Saturday Superstarcade, and that's where we stand. So that's why I call it that. So, and not necessarily I played the video games on Saturdays. I tried to, because, like, okay, time to wind down and stuff. But sometimes things change, plans change, everything changes. No more football for the Patriots. They're done. So, and since both us and the Sofas was canceled last night, postponed till next week, I will appear on both us and Sofas. I made a promise to Mr. Garrison Newkirk that I will appear on the show to acknowledge the Buffalo Bills. Even though I am a Patriots fan, I want to be classy and be respectful, and that's what I want to do. So that's what I'm going to do. So I made my promise, and I'm keeping it. Remember that. It was a friendly wager. I lost down the bet. I'm coming on the show to acknowledge the Buffalo Bills. No cooking shows. I ain't cooking roast beef and crap like that. I'll probably burn down the kitchen. I don't like roast beef, even though Mr. Gary calls me Big Beefy E, but might I digress. We're going to have a little bit of fun, regardless of what happens, man. I'll tell you one thing, we have a lot of fun here. So, I have a lot of fun to show. And if you like this video or any other videos that you do, just to let you know, press that subscribe and ring the bell for notifications. Press the like buttons, everything else, and say, hey, I like your show. Can I subscribe? I say, yes, you can subscribe. All right, we're going to have a little bit of fun here. Just so you know, NXT 2.0 tonight, Malcolm Bivens, or I like to call him hashtag Big Mouth Bivens, has run his mouth for far too long. And Walter is going to face Roderick Strong tonight. What a match that was. Malcolm Bivens, all he does is too much of this. Although Roderick Strong and the Creed Brothers versus Imperium, Diamond Mine versus Imperium, that'll be a heck of a feud I like to see. So, but might I digress. Let's talk about what happened on Raw last night, because a lot of stuff happened on Raw. Becky of the Raw Event Center for January 17, 2022, in which yesterday was Martin Luther King Day. So, Becky Lynch kicks off Monday Night Raw, addresses the crowd in Tulsa about her title match against Doudrop. Doudrop interrupts Becky Lynch, and Doudrop says she's gonna show Becky Lynch that she's gonna win the title, and she proves it. Bianca Belair comes out and says, you know, you're scared of me, but I'm gonna enter the Royal Rumble. Liv Morgan comes out, declares her entry into the Women's Royal Rumble matchup. Now he's two more spots down. There's like seven spots left to go. So everybody wants their favorite superstar or legend in the Royal Rumble. In this case, a lot of people on Twitter want Melina in that Royal Rumble match. I want Melina in the Royal Rumble match, I should say. Melina's brother, PJ, he wants Melina in the Royal Rumble matchup. Let's get Melina in there. Hashtag Melina for Rumble. Let's do it. Let's get her in there. Let's speak out. Let's tell the WWE, hey, we want Melina in there. If Mickey James could come in there, why not Melina? Come on. Come on, WWE. Chop, chop. Let's get to it. But then again, we could see the Iconics make their return as Knockouts Tag Team Champions in the Royal Rumble matchup, too. Interesting situations we live here, folks. Anyways, Belair, so that's what there is. Then after the commercial break, Alpha Academy were preparing for their graduation ceremony, which is really cool. Then they had the women's tag team matchup, Bianca Belair and Liv Morgan, against Becky Lynch and Doudrop. And Doudrop decided to go in for business for herself, tags herself in. Becky Lynch, as she was knocked out. Doudrop made the matchup after she broke up the count. Made the pinfall herself on Liv Morgan, wins the matchup, and then she bonsai drops Becky Lynch post-match. Message sent, message delivered then, Miss Lynch. Ireland versus Scotland. What a rivalry this is going to turn out to be. Reggie and Dana Brooke were talking to Edge and Beth Phoenix, getting advice from them, because Edge and Beth Phoenix are not only veterans, but they're Hall of Famers, too. And then, Beth Phoenix did a word of encouragement to Dana Brooke, said, that means a lot to me. So, anyways, and then they go over to talk to Damian Priest, you know, Damian Priest gives him a hug and all that, ask Edge for advice, and then Beth Phoenix got a note from Maryse inviting her to the ring. I smell setup! A little bit more on that situation. And then Kevin Owens was talking to Damian Priest, and Damian Priest says, you don't want the Damian side to come out of me and all that, so... The Kevin Owens show, Kevin Owens was there, and Seth freaking Rollins was the guest. And then Kevin Owens has officially entered himself into the Royal Rumble matchup, the men's Royal Rumble matchup, which is something. And then Damian Priest interrupts them. And then they said the match happens right now. They went to commercial break. And Veer Mahan coming to Monday Night Raw. Hey, WWE, here's a question. When is Veer Mahan coming to Raw? Is he going to enter the Men's Royal Rumble match? Sure hope so. Jeepers. Or is it after the Royal Rumble? You never know. So, Damian Priest versus Kevin Owens. And Kevin Owens pinned Damian Priest clean. That's a shocker, right? First time Damian Priest lost a long one-on-one matchup clean in a long time. And now, if Kevin Owens does not win the Royal Rumble matchup, you know that Kevin Owens pinned Damian Priest could have a shot at the United States Heavyweight Championship. And Sarah Schreiber interviewed Nikki A.S.H. after her brutal attack on her former friend and partner, Rhea Ripley. And Nikki A.S.H. claims that Rhea Ripley's the villain and all that. She may dress like a villain, but I think Rhea Ripley's got her heart of gold inside. You know? So then we go to the Alpha Academy graduation ceremony. And I don't know if the fans boo Chad Gable. Don't boo education. You don't boo education, man. We're not booing education, Chad. We're booing a condescending, arrogant attitude that you and Otis are displaying here. And he doesn't know Otis's last name. It's Dosovic. Dosovic. I don't know why people would... WWE. So, anyways. Riddle comes out in the cap and gown of his own, which is very colorful. And and said, we're running our rematch. And then he said, you want a rematch? You have to beat us in an academic challenge. And you see Otis like, what? Academic challenge? Oh, boy. This ought to be fun. But then, and then Matt Riddle, you know, tried to do something. Otis comes out of the ring. And then all of a sudden, it was a setup because Randy Orton RKO'd Chad Gable out of nowhere. And then Randy Orton grabs the microphone. We accept your challenge. And so I was like, ah. So, and then Randy Orton goes, I like what you're doing, man. I like what you're doing. It was great. So Vince McMahon and Austin Theory talking about the loss to Finn Balor. And Vince is just saying, if you don't beat Finn Balor, I'm going to beat the crap out of you. I'm going to hurt you so bad and all that. How do you motivate a guy, right? So Finn Balor against Austin Theory one-on-one. Austin Theory did pick up the victory over Finn Balor. So that pleases Mr. McMahon, doesn't it? Sarah Schreiber interviewed Rhea Ripley. And Rhea Ripley says, I got to show Nikki A.S.H. why I am the Nightmare and why I'm this and that. It was supposed to have a matchup. And then Queen Zelina and Carmella, the women's tag team champions, mind you. Don't forget, the Bella Twins are coming back to the Royal Rumble. Maybe if Queen Zelina and Carmella keep running their mouths, maybe the Bella Twins want to be tag team champs, women's tag team champs. Well, it'll be very interesting to see if that develops. So they started addressing Rhea Ripley, started making fun of her and all that. Then Nikki A.S.H. blindsides Rhea Ripley from behind. Beats her to the point where the matchup was a no contest. And the match didn't even ring. The bell didn't even ring. So I expected these ladies to fight until WrestleMania. Trust me on that one. But I think Queen Zelina and Carmella may have their hands full. If they run their mouths about the Bella Twins, when they come back, they want to be women's tag team champions. So if I were Queen Zelina and Carmella, I suggest to shine those belts up. Because might go home with the Bellas. You never know. And then Reggie was trying to get his ready for his match against Omos, which is the odds are against him, obviously. While they were talking, R-Truth, Tozawa, and Tamina, and a referee were all eating popcorn. Acting like they're watching in a movie theater. It was so funny to see. Like, who knew that Tamina had a sense of humor? So, anyways, I'm sure it was R-Truth's idea. R-Truth comes up with so many crazy things. I love R-Truth still. He's still the man. And so, Danny Brooks trying to motivate him. So Reggie goes, okay, we'll go. So he goes, Reggie versus Omos. And Akira Tozawa. Tazira? Where did that come from? Akira Tozawa, R-Truth, and Tamina were trying to chase Dana Brooke down for the 24-7 title and referee. And while that's going on, they thought, oh, Reggie distracts them. Omos grabs him, slams him down. 1, 2, 3. And then Maryse comes out, addresses the Tulsa crowd, makes fun of them, calls out Beth Phoenix. Beth Phoenix comes out with Edge. And then Miz tried to blindside Edge. Edge was ready for it. But then as Beth Phoenix turned around, Maryse attacks Beth Phoenix with a pocketbook. By the way, I looked at the pocketbook as Beth Phoenix went down in a heap. I said, that's got to be loaded. Got to be a loaded pocketbook. Sure enough, I was right. They put a brick in the freaking pocketbook. Big mistake, Maryse. I think once Beth Phoenix recovers from this, Beth Phoenix is going to be full of PMV. And I think Beth Phoenix is going to glam slam Maryse through the mat. You know, there's one thing I haven't considered. A lot of y'all considered what surprises should be in the Royal Rumble. Maybe the recently released Lana could be in that. Could be a surprise entry in the Royal Rumble. We haven't heard Lana doing much since she left the WWE. That could be another surprise. There's 7 spots left. Well, I know Asuka's rumored to come back. So you never know. Because she's clear to go. We'll see what happens there. Yeah. So there's that. And the Street Profits and the Mysterios were talking about, you know, winning the Royal Rumble and all that. Yeah, 29 guys. Yeah, you say there's 29 guys that are going to throw us out there. Is it 20? You mean 28 and one of you. So they had an 8-man tag team matchup. The Street Profits and the Mysterios did against the Dirty Dogs, Apollo Crews, and Commander Aziz. The Profits and Mysterios did win the matchup. And then the Mysterios tossed the Street Profits over the top ropes, and that's how it's really done, right? And then Dominic, in his young and experienced mind, was leaning over, and Rey Mysterio tosses him out. Gotta learn, Dominic. You gotta learn that. And all the Street Profits and Dominic are looking, oh, my God, what happened? It was pretty funny. We know Rey Mysterio goes, this may be a possibility. You never know. So, as Miz and Maryse trying to make their getaway, Kevin Patrick interviewed them, and then they started making out because next week there'll be a big birthday party bash for Maryse. Whoopie doo. Edge and Beth Phoenix, I hope, for God's sakes, they ruin it. Anyways, I'm a cold-hearted person. And then Alexa Bliss and the Psychiatrist Part 2. What do you see, Lily? What do you see, Lily? Lily, Lily. All she can think about is Lily. Poor Alexa Bliss. And then they had a matchup of... Royal Rumble title challengers. Bobby Lashley challenging Brock Lesnar for the WWE Championship. Next week's going to be a weigh-in. A weigh-in! That's ought to be fun. Because they're going to get ugly. You know, I thought the contract signings are bad enough. Weigh-ins? We've seen weigh-ins sometimes get really rowdy sometimes. So, and then Seth freaking Rollins challenging his former Shield brother, Roman Reigns, the tribal chief, the head of the table for the Universal title. And then as the match went on, the Hurt Business blindsided Bobby Lashley once again. That's Shelton Benjamin and Shelton Alexander. They started busting up Lashley, which gives Lashley the win by disqualification. And then as Rollins was surviving in the ring, the Usos came through the crowd and attacked Seth freaking Rollins. This is getting more interesting by the moment, let me tell you. It's going to be a lot of fun. Okay? So, that's all the time we have here on the show. Watch NXT 2.0. The Dusty Cup Tournament Classic starts tonight. I think you saw my event center on that not too long ago to tell you who was in the tournament. That's the men's Dusty Cup. The women's Dusty Cup. The women's the men's Dusty Cup Classic starts tonight. We don't know who's going to fight what. We all know that Volter, the winner of this Dusty Cup Classic, will be challenging Imperium for the NXT Tag Team Championship. So there's that. there's that. Also, whoever in the women's tournament, I think the winner of that tournament will challenge Toxic Attraction for the NXT Women's Tag Team Championship. Might I digress? Here we go. Tonight, though, Roderick Strong versus Walter. Big Mouth Bivens at it again. Hey, Malcolm Bivens, you shouldn't have run your mouth, boy. Tonight, that little meanie Charles Barkley wannabe is going to find out what happens when you mess with Walter. Believe me. Yeah, the mat is sacred, but you know what? But not your face, that's for sure. Anyways, I'll see you guys later. This is episode 896 of WEML-TV, Channel 77, hosted by me, Eric Lima, the five-time Bumbling Bozos Bozy Awards nominee. I will see you guys on the next episode. Until then, wish you all the peace, all the love, and God's blessings from him above through me to you. I will see you guys later. Have a wonderful, wonderful day. Peace.